What is going on, guys? Politics Gaming here. Today, I am going to be doing another live stream for today. Today, we are basically going to be playing Power and Revolution, but we are going to be doing it as we are analyzing the news that has come out in response to a lot of what has been going on today. There has been a major announcement in the news that Brett Kavanaugh now officially has the votes to be confirmed to the Supreme Court of the United States. The United States Senate is the only branch of the Congress that actually votes on the Supreme Court nominees and stuff like that. So we are definitely going to be looking into something something is going to happen in the next few days, especially tomorrow. Tomorrow is actually when the vote is supposed to be held. So we are definitely going to be watching closely that tomorrow. I actually get off work at about 3 tomorrow or 4. I'm actually going to have to check over that real quick, and I'm looking at it right now. Tomorrow I get off at 3:30. So if the vote has not happened, then as soon as I get home, I will go ahead and watch over that. So that is going to be a very important step into basically trying to figure out who is going to be in the Supreme Court for the next generation, or maybe even two generations. What is the consequence of actually having a conservative justice, or more of a justice that is not more liberal-leaning? What is the consequence of that? Honestly, I don't think there is a consequence of having a liberal or conservative justice. I think that it is basically the consequence of having politicized and bipolarized societies in our country. And we're definitely going down a road that is basically telling us, okay, well, we are very bipolar in our politics, so we are definitely going to be doing something along the lines of trying to make ourselves say, okay, well, we want this, and this. I don't think it's going to go as far as repealing Roe v. Wade. I highly doubt that Roe v. Wade is going to be touched by Brett Kavanaugh and the new Supreme Court layout. I think that's a scare tactic that is actually being used by several people, including the Democrats. It's not something that is going to be possible, and even if it was possible, then it definitely would be hated by a lot of people, and there would be lots of social unrest to try and overturn that decision. But Brett Kavanaugh and Neil Gorsuch, even if Brett Kavanaugh were to support the repeal of Roe v. Wade, then I feel like Neil Gorsuch would actually save the day, because Neil Gorsuch is actually very much more of a constitutionalist. He doesn't think that things should be messed with. And so that is actually something that is probably going to happen. Which actually, I am actually going to probably pull up a 270 or something like that. Try to see if we can actually go ahead and analyze what this means for the 2018 midterms. Which actually, I can go ahead and pull that up now, because we are actually going to do a little bit again of an analysis because of just the blowback that this decision can actually pull up. So we're gonna go ahead and pull up. I'm gonna go ahead and do it right now. I already have 270. No, not 270. I already have a Real Clear Politics pulled up. So we're gonna go ahead and pull up 270 in a minute. So let me actually go ahead and get all of that set up. And one. All right. You guys saw a little bit of my Discord there. All right. So we are going to go ahead and pull this up right here. So we're going to go ahead and go over to the Senate map, and we're going to see how this affects the 2018 midterm elections. Now, there's a couple of basic hand-me-downs that I believe is going to happen. Joe Manchin is definitely going to benefit off of him, because this is actually one of the things, is that Joe Manchin actually did vote in favor of, is going to vote in favor of Brett Kavanaugh. So we are definitely going to get one Democratic senator to actually vote in favor of that. Whether he will be voted out in retaliation, or whether the Democrats of the United States will separate themselves from him, he could end up actually joining the Republican Party because of that. So we're definitely going to go ahead and leave West Virginia in the Democratic column. However, Indiana, Joe Donnelly has already voiced his opposition to that. Florida is a completely different, but I do believe Rick Scott, that is something that I've always been saying since the beginning, is that Rick Scott is going to pull off in the state of Florida. Claire McCaskill is definitely going to be retaliated against because of her vote against it, and plus of her dwindling popularity. I do believe that she is going to lose her election in November. North Dakota, we are seeing Kramer leading in double digits in North Dakota. This is actually a very, very big opportunity for the Republicans, that they can finally flip the state of North Dakota, which has been under Democratic rule since, I believe, around 2012. So we are definitely going to be putting North Dakota into the Republican column. In any case, I do have a feeling that Arizona could stay with the Republicans. It's not for sure, but it is going to be a possibility. Nevada could stay with the Republic, or flip toward the Democratic Party, and John Tester could actually keep his nomination and keep his seat in the state of Montana. So this is going to be a possible prediction map that I am going to have right here. I'm going to go ahead and put Texas a little deeper into red, as I do believe that Ted Cruz is definitely going to win in the state of Texas. I did have a little bit of a doubts about Ted Cruz and his ability to actually win. But after seeing those debate performances with Beto O'Rourke and Ted Cruz, I definitely have a very, very strong feeling that Beto O'Rourke will lose the election in the state of Texas. While Arizona will stay red, Florida will flip red, Tennessee will stay red, Indiana will flip red, Missouri will flip red, and North Dakota, in any case, either way, is definitely going to flip red. Heidi Heitkamp is actually starting to lose her popularity in the state of North Dakota, and she is definitely not the prime choice that people are looking at in North Dakota, and her vote against Brett Kavanaugh will definitely hurt her in the midterm elections next month. So we are now 1 month and 1 day from the midterm elections. This is going to be what my thing is going to be about. I really think this is going to be the best case scenario for the Republicans. In any case, Arizona will go blue, and Indiana will stay blue. And in a bad case, which basically it would be bad. Indiana would stay blue, Missouri would stay blue, and they would only pick up North Dakota, which it would leave them with the 51-49, which would I believe be a gain for the Democrats. So that would definitely hurt in the end for the Republicans. But with that, this is going to go ahead and be my actual prediction. In a good case scenario for the Republicans, this is going to be it. But in a average case scenario, minus Arizona, that is going to be my prediction for that. So yeah, that is actually that is gonna go ahead and be my little prediction for that. Yeah, I think I'm actually gonna go ahead and change the name of this live stream, just the Kavanaugh confirmation and midterm analysis, and then I can go ahead and play a little bit of my summer meme, since you guys really, really don't like my summer meme. And let me go ahead and so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this. And we can go ahead and continue talking. Because more likely, what is going to happen is that... I'm going to go ahead and import those music files because they never import for some reason. So what is going to happen is that Kavanaugh is definitely going to be accepted tomorrow. If I can broadcast the vote, I will. So we definitely need to... There's going to be a lot of protests. There's going to be a lot of hate against the Republicans. However, I believe this will energize the Republican Party because, in fact... this is actually energizing both sides, and here's why I think that, is that, Democrats are believing, okay, well, like, I'm a sexual assault survivor, I can't be believed because everyone is going to, like, say, oh yeah, well, you're just a liar, blah, blah, blah. And then you have the other side that is going to say, okay, I want the Supreme Court justice to stay on the Supreme Court. So, why can I not just vote for Republican candidates, and then we can actually, keep the conservative justice, such as Brett Kavanaugh, on a Supreme Court. So, that is actually going to be a debate that is going to happen, and is going to end on November 6, 2018, next month, just a day from now. And we are definitely going to see the pinnacle of American society. We are going to see how partisan this country has become. And it is going to be an interesting day. It is going to be a sad day because of how divided this country is becoming. I'm not too excited for it. I am excited because it is an election. I obviously am loving elections and stuff like that, but it is going to be very, very sad because of just the amount of division that is pulling this country apart and the amount of rhetoric on both sides that is just squeezing us by now. And it's going to be interesting. I'm not sitting here saying, okay, well, this is going to be good, this is going to be bad. I'm just saying it's going to be an interesting day. Whether you believe Kavanaugh is bad, or whether you... Cardjack? Oh, that's in the back. Whether you believe Kavanaugh is bad, or whether you believe he is going to be a good Supreme Court justice, it's a hard time for our country, and it's something that I'm not gonna say it's going to be the best day that has ever happened, but at the same time, we are going to we're gonna see how divided this country is. Honestly, it's confusing. In my own opinion, oh man, it's Sunday. I can't go to the Litari. Actually, I'm gonna have to like mute my mic real quick. I'll be right back. All right, sorry about that. So Darth Raven, I've never seen you in the live stream, so welcome to the live stream.
Annammeko arvon sille?
Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains.
Just so you know, I bet I'm not going to be able to monetize this video, so but I don't care. This is John Denver. This is a great song.
Painted on the sky, misty taste the moonshine, teardrop in my eye, country roads, take me home to the place.
To the place I belong, West Virginia, Mountain Mama, take me home, country roads, take me roads, take me home, to the place I belong. West Virginia, Mountain Mama, take me home. Oh my God. Ah, good.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
I just demonetized my own video because I know I'm getting no money from this. No one likes to watch My Summer Car, so. Ooh, that hurts my ears.
The sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone.
Kuulijoille, yön armon hiljaisuudessa. Ja kuten aina, kiehtovaksi ohjelman tekee se, että itsekin luen ne ensimmäistä kertaa.
When my eyes were stared by the flash of a neon light.
This is what my channel has gone to. It's gone from successful 1,500 subscribers all the way to just listening to Sound of Silence while building a fucking car.
Kyllenevät. Kansa toivoo paljon enemmän.
JJ already did 270 early, be quiet.
Onko elä-
My voice is never shared. All right, let's start this shit. Woo! Let's go. Oh god, that's loud. It's like I'm getting surrounded by bees. Alright, let's run into the water. Just kidding, I don't want to die. I need this bike. Whoa! Whoa! I need to start taking this little thing to town. I'll probably fucking die though. Alright, let's go ahead and park it. And... knew it. Engine always stalls for some reason. I don't know why. Yeah. We know it's all the sound of silence. Oh, I can pick it up. PG has lost it, guys. Hell yeah, I have! Oh, here's the song again. Hang on. Listen, guys. Almost heaven. West Virginia. Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is older, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, blowing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, Mountain Mama, take me home, country roads. All my memories gather round her, modest lady, stranger in blue water, dark and dusty. Made it all the sky, Mr. Tins and moonshine, teardrops in my eyes, country roads, take me home to the place I belong. Okay, I'm done. I lost like 2 viewers because I was singing. Don't worry, I actually have to get off in a second, but like, I am totally making a little thing about that. Radio reminds me of my home far away. Next time I'm just gonna get blasted drunk. Alright, let's turn this song off before John Denver starts trying to beat my ass. Alright guys, I'm going to have to go ahead and head out for this one. This is going to be the final live stream for today. Thank you guys so much for watching this terrible live stream that I have held. That had a little bit of Power and Revolution, a little bit of 270, and a lot of it of me singing Take Me Home Country Roads by John Denver. So guys, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Please don't subscribe to me because my channel is complete trash, and please let me die because that's all I ever deserve. Thank you guys so much for watching this live stream. This one is going to be the worst live stream I have ever held in the history of my channel. Thank you guys so much for supporting me, and non-ironically, I actually do appreciate you guys' support. I'm sorry for the lack of content thereof. That I have been sort of like ignoring and stuff like that, but I will get to it. It's just like my work has scheduled me a lot. I think probably next schedule should be a little bit more better, but I don't know if it will or will not. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna leave it right there. Thank you guys so much for watching this live stream. I'll see you guys in the next one. Make sure to take it home for Country Roads. And I think October 27th, I am actually going to hold a live stream, which is going to be the official Since I already have pre-ordered Fallout 76, October 27th is whenever the beta starts, and I will definitely be here on my channel to show it to you guys first. Obviously, I'm not going to be able to show it to you first, because Xbox One players are the ones who are going to be able to do that, so there's going to be a lot of Fallout 76 content out there, but once PC actually gets into the game, then that's what's going to happen. Which I actually, one interesting thing is that it's actually, Fallout 76, the beta, actually is going to start on October 23rd for Xbox One players, which is actually very interesting, because in the lore of the game, the Great War, the war that basically called for, or basically ended human civilization as we know it, started and ended in 2 hours on October 23rd, 2077. And I think I actually called it like way whenever I first pre-ordered it, and they announced the beta, and then they said, okay, well, it's going to come out for Xbox One first, and I was like, okay, I actually think it's going to happen on October 23rd, because that's whenever the lore says the war starts. So, guys, I'm going to go ahead and leave it right there. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care, God bless, and something, politics, gaming, trash channel. Thank you, bye.